Hello and welcome. I'm Danette Kubanda, and joining me today for a very special Zoom interview is Sage Soraya. She's an award-winning documentary and fine art photographer, a filmmaker who spent the last several years traveling the deep interiors of Asia and the Americas, capturing images that tell stories of remote cultures. She's currently working on a documentary, The Dance of Freedom, and on a coffee table book of her photographs. Thank you so much for being with us today, Sage.
Hi, Danette. Thank you so much for having me. It's such an honor.
So how did you get started photographing the world?
Well, I've been a photographer since I was 10 years old. And it's my way of stopping time, you know, and really observing the world around me. And so when I was in my early 20s, I was doing a lot of landscape photography because America has just so much beautiful landscape. And it was so beautiful. However, in my early 20s, I was at a talk and a photographic exhibition by this Canadian ethnobotanist and National Geographic explorer in residence by the name of Wade Davis, who is this beautiful man who has spent so many years with all these remote cultures all around the world. And so he was talking about them and he was talking about how they live and this ancient wisdom that is sort of fading away and the languages that are fading away. And everything that he was describing about them felt to me like this, something that I felt very connected to, because he was saying that, you know, these are ways that the modern world, in the modern world, we have forgotten, and that these are strange ways for us, but it didn't feel strange to me. I felt like very connected. And so I knew that I needed to go out into the world to these tribes and live with them and understand this ancient wisdom and, you know, take whatever I could for. So what I mean is, it actually started for me as a means of self-exploration. I was very curious about these ways of living. And so I went into I sold my car in LA, quit my job, and I just took off and I spent a lot of time with them to learn. And then the natural next step was to take photographs of them. After spending so much time with them, to take photographs of their daily lives and their portraits and document their wisdom.
Oh, that sounds so beautiful. What are some of the biggest lessons you learned from the people and the cultures you visited, and even from the obstacles you must have faced during your journeys?
You know, from as traveling as a solo woman, I faced a lot of obstacles, but one of the biggest lessons I learned from my own personal obstacles and my own personal journey was that people are inherently good. And that when we go into these lands with respect and reverence for their culture and the way they live, I was welcomed in eventually. You know, I started to get very openly welcomed in because I respected them so much. So I lost my fear of a lot of things, you know. But, you know, what I learned from them, it's very hard to put it in points, because essentially living with these indigenous people who still live in these ancient ways, every single day is a spiritual experience. And every single thing they do is just so beautiful in a way that they respect the land around them and they respect everything. And so coexistence was one of the biggest things I learned. Coexistence with the land around us, the animals that live around us, the plants, and even the human beings that we live around. That sort of coexistence was one of the biggest things. But another thing, I spent a lot of time with the indigenous women in various different cultures. And what was common is that they are so strong and powerful and rooted in their femininity. And it was very fresh. It was like such a, it was really nice to see the way these women show up for each other and the way they embody their femininity. It's a lot to get into, but that was one of the things. And then one of the last things that I also learned, one of the more important ones, was do not fear death. We read in a lot of books about how death is a part of life and stuff, but a lot of these different cultures live it. So in the Tibetan culture, in a couple cultures in Indonesia, among some the sadhus of India, there's this lack of fear of death. And a lot of these people live with their dead. The Indonesian people, the Thanatarajans, they have dead bodies in their home and the kids are around that. And when you live around that energy, you can't fear death. So that was like yeah, I could go on forever, but these were some of the things that I learned that are, I can think about at the top of my head right now.
Oh, you make us want to go on a journey with you. This is amazing.
Please do.
And I know it's important to you to give back. How do you do that?
So, you know, I have a lot of photographic exhibitions. I believe that as long as we look at them as these faraway cultures and we objectify them, they remain objects of fascination. But the minute we share their stories, they become something that they become a part of us. And so I share, you know, I have these gigantic portraits that I've printed out, and I have exhibitions where I speak about these cultures and what I've learned from them and their practices and their environmental practices, which are so important today with climate change. So I do that. I also have fine art prints that I offer for available for sale, so that a big portion of the proceeds that come from these sales go back to the tribes that I've spent time with. Also, when I'm in these lands, I always grab some of the kids, the more curious kids, and I have them work with me. So I'm like, you know, I help them, I have them help me set up the tripod, or I have them, like, you know, look through the camera, because what I've seen is that when they see that there's this foreign person so interested in their culture, then they feel like they're drawn to their own culture. They feel like there's something in there that they might want to learn. So it's really nice to see them come back to their cultures by seeing other, to their own traditions, by seeing outsiders show an interest in it.
Oh, that's so amazing. Thank you so much for sharing all of this. To learn more about Sage, her, all of her work, to view her beautiful photographs, please visit her website at sagesaraya.com. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Danette.